Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today we're going to utilize the HCSRO4 ultrasonic sensor's capability to measure the distance of targeted objects by interfacing it with an Arduino, a WS2812B addressable RGB LED strip, and a 10K potentiometer to control its brightness level in order for us to make a distance-activated nightlight with brightness control. It would basically perform the same functions as an HCSR501 PIR motion sensor by acting as a switch or a trigger to turn on a light, but in a more precise-ish way. I've used PIR motion sensors before.
Click right here to check it out, by the way.
And I've tried to use one for this same purpose, but due to space constraints, I can't use it to trigger a nightlight for my room because every time I or my dog moves when I try to sleep, the light would turn on, and the minimum or shortest sensing distance you can set it to is just 3 meters, which is a little bit too much. So, I opted to use this one. Also, just like on all of my previous Arduino projects, all the necessary links including the sources, codes, schematics, and other good stuff would be available in the description down below. Let's go! Here are the things that we need. For this project, I'm going to use my newly acquired Arduino Nano Every to manage, well, everything. You can also use other MCUs if you want, of course. The star of the show, an HCSRO4 ultrasonic sensor, a WS2812B addressable RGB LED strip to light up the dark. You can also use other light sources like what I've mentioned earlier. A 10K potentiometer to control the brightness level of the RGB LED strip. A breadboard, of course. A few hookup wires and jumper cables. And lastly, a data cable. As you can see on the schematic diagram, wiring it is pretty easy because we only have to deal with 6 pins. I'm thinking that maybe we should just connect everything first before we do some tests. Alright, let's get our breadboard. Connect the Arduino Nano just like this. Connect our jumper cables to the ultrasonic sensor. In my case, yellow is VCC or 5 volts, so I have to connect it to the 5 volts rail of the breadboard. Blue is echo, which is supposed to be connected to digital pin number 4. Green is trigger, which is connected to digital pin number 3. And purple is ground, which is connected to the ground rail of the breadboard. Next up is the 10K potentiometer. Let's put this one right here and then connect the first pin from the left to the 5 volts rail, the third pin to the ground rail, and the second pin to Arduino's analog pin number 0. While we're at it, let's connect Arduino's 5 volts and ground to the 5 volts and ground rail of the breadboard as well. And lastly, let's connect the WS2812B addressable RGB LED strip's input pin to Arduino's digital pin number 6, then 5 volts to 5 volts rail and ground to ground rail of the breadboard, like so. Now that we have connected everything, let's test the ultrasonic sensor using its library sample code. Do take note though that we can also use the Arduino IDE for this. I just prefer VS Code with Platform IO IDE extension nowadays.
I have a video about it, by the way. Click right here if you want to check it out.
After creating our project file, let's go ahead and add the ultrasonic sensors library. To do that, first, let's search for SRO4 and add it to our project folder. Let's just pick this one. This library was created by Mr. Stefano P. and Eric Simois. Thank you, sirs. Add to project. Sonic test, then click on add. Then let's just copy the sample code right here for some tests. Okay, first let's remove these two since we're only going to use one sensor. The code works pretty much just like with other sensors. We declare the input pins, read them, and display the values. That's it. Let's plug in the Arduino to the computer. Let's check if the board is being detected. There it is on COM15. Click on build. Then, upload the code. Now, let's click on serial monitor to see if the distance is being displayed. What? Why is it displaying 0? Oh, I forgot to change the pin numbers. Okay, let's upload the code again. There we go. To check the accuracy of the sensor, I'm going to use my ruler. The serial monitor should be displaying 4 centimeters. And there it is. Now, if we move it back, 5 centimeters, 8 centimeters, 10 centimeters, 12 centimeters, well, you get the gist. Now we know that it's working properly, let's move on to the final code. I basically just copied and pasted the brightness control code for my WS2812B RGB LED brightness control and color mixing project.
Click right here to check it out.
And then merged it with just a few lines of code from the ultrasonic sensor library sample code. Hence, the omission of the potentiometer and RGB LED tests, because we've already tested those on the previous project. The code is pretty much just composed of sample codes from their own libraries, and it works like this. Not really sure if I should explain everything again, but why not? Arduino.h is just a necessary addition to use the Arduino platform on platform I/O. Ultrasonic.h is the SRO Force library. And Fastled.h is, of course, the Fastled library. NumLEDs is the number of LED chips on the RGB LED strip. Data pin is where the data input of the RGB LED strip is connected. Ultrasonic is the function that we quote unquote call when we use the variable ultrasonic1, which contains the emitter or trigger and receiver or echo pins. CRGB is the representation of an RGB pixel, and LEDs is the block of memory that will be used for storing and manipulating LED data of the connected LEDs. This is the analog in, out serial sample code from the Arduino IDE to convert the digital value from analog read using the map function. Outval represents the remapping of the potentiometer values or potval from 0 to 1023 and 0 to 255. On the void setup, serial begin was added to start the serial communication and to enable us to use the serial monitor. AddLEDs tells the library that there's a stand.
Is that a JoJo reference?
AddLEDs tells the library that there's a strand, or in this case, 10WS2812B chips that are connected to digital pin number 6. Not really sure, but GRB is just the color arrangement of the LEDs, I think. The LEDs connected to digital pin number 6 will use the LED array LEDs and will control the number of LEDs specified on NumLEDs. On the void loop, potval is the value that is being read by analog read from pot, which is analog pin 0. If ultrasonic 1 is less than or equal to 10, means that if the trigger and echo pin's value is less than or equal to 10 cm, it will call the color utility function from the fastled library to fill the 10 LED chips with the color orange red. According to the Arduino references, analog write would write the values to the pin where it's connected to, which was supposed to be data pin, but still worked with NumLEDs, and to the value and outval. Fastled brightness is a fastled command that, well, sets the brightness. Usually, the set brightness command is a fixed value, but since we need to change it, we added the outval instead. Fastled.show basically just tells the library to show the data or light up the LED strip. Delay 5000 is the duration of how long the LED strip would be lit.
5 seconds to be exact.
Before starting to send and receive trigger and echo values again. Else fastled.clear is the instruction of what the RGB LEDs should do when the ultrasonic sensor is not reading a value that is less than or equal to 10 cm, which just means to not light up the LED strip when the values are greater than 10 cm. And this last delay right here is the duration of when the serial monitor should display the distance data, which is every 100 milliseconds. For example, if the target's distance from the sensor is less than or equal to 10 cm, it would keep the LED strip lit up until the target's distance becomes greater than 10 cm, where it would turn the LED strip off. And that's pretty much it, really. Okay, let's do some tests again. So, if I wave my hand near the sensor, it should make the RGB LED strip light up. See that? Let me turn off the lights. Let's increase the brightness level. Whoop! Increase the brightness to full. Whoop! Alright, let's change the orientation of this. Let's get our model, or quote-unquote target. As we can see here, Jollibee's distance from the ultrasonic sensor is less than 10 cm, which means that the LED strip should stay lit up and ignore its duration period of 5 seconds. Let me turn off more lights. As we move Jollibee or the sensor farther apart from each other, the LED strip should turn off. Just like that. Before we forget, we should also test the LED strip's power consumption to let us decide if we should use an external power supply or just use the Arduino Nano directly to both power and control it. So let's get our multimeter, turn the dial to milliamps, make sure that the probes are connected to COM and ammeter terminals, connect one probe to the 5V supply of the LED strip and connect the other one to the positive rail of the breadboard. Alright, let's plug in the Arduino and then see just how much current the LED strip is pulling from the Arduino's regulators. As we can see here, at mid brightness level, the strip is pulling 65 milliamps, 17 milliamps at quarter brightness, and about 138 milliamps at full brightness. Pretty low, isn't it? Well, that's because we chose a color that would not require all the LEDs in the chip to be turned on and at full brightness. And according to the Arduino Nano Every's 80MB 4809 processor's datasheet, both its 5V and ground pin can provide up to 200 milliamps of current. I know that basing my decision on the absolute maximum rating is wrong, but the total amperage of the LED strip is way lower than the maximum anyway. And that's only when the LED strip is at full brightness. In addition, we're only going to turn on the strip for just 5 seconds every time the ultrasonic sensor's threshold is reached, so I don't think that it would be that bad. Besides the really simple and easy to follow schematic diagram and code, I think this project can be used as an example on how effortless it is to merge or interface two or more components together and make them work according to our preference. It is indeed the lazy way to do it. But for the purpose that it's going to serve, I think it's perfectly fine. So yeah, thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.